In this video, I want to talk about people who play the victim. Now, this is different from people who actually are the victim. This would be about people who, some would say, have narcissistic behaviors. I don't know anybody who's ever been diagnosed with narcissistic personality disorder, and these days I don't know anybody who does. But, yeah, they have narcissistic behaviors, and they play as though they're the victim when they're actually trying to or wanting to victimize other people, okay? And I've seen this in both males and females. I would say that males do it a little bit different, but not always than, you know, females. Not always, and vice versa, no. So, okay, now one of the main ways I have seen them play the victim is to show the world, you know, whomever's around, that they really love and care about somebody. Now, it can be somebody who's actually, that you know, or somebody you don't even know, you know, that they really love or care, or this person, you know, they just love them. They're really caring when they don't. They really don't. But that is used to, then they turn around and say that this person, some, you know, later on somehow hurt them, somehow did them wrong. And they do that to get attention, and sometimes they do it as a smear campaign against that other person. Any way around it, they're trying to get that attention that they really want. Okay. And another thing that could be hiding underneath all this, and they're very skilled with this, okay. Another thing that could be hiding is that they're actually sexist. Now, this is not just men being sexist against women. It can be women being sexist against men. Okay, and they're hiding it. This hate inside of them, they have it come out that way. Okay, and it doesn't just show up, you know, it's not only about the opposite sex. It can, you know, the hate. It can also be about a different ethnic group than their own, or ethnic groups. And they can have that prejudice against somebody different than them, than they are, you know. Or it can also be about ageism. You know, these are the, you know, the racism, the sexism, the ageism. They have something against somebody who's younger, you know, people who are younger, or people who are older. And the way they go about this is so sneaky that people will believe the story of how they were abused, they say, you know, become the victim of people from whatever group it is that they truly hate. And they could hate all of them, but they play the victim. So people will listen to the story and say, well, yeah, I understand why you're angry. You see what I'm saying? People who are like them. Okay. And with them, it's not something that they will say, you know, that is a generalization, or they say that it's just a few, it's not everybody. They will say that it's everybody from that generation, or everybody from, you know, every male or every female, or it's always every. It's never, you know, just more like a, would it be an adjective? Boy, I need to go back to school and learn English, my grammar, huh? But you know what I'm saying, that it's always like a, qualifier, something like that. It's you know, like if I say somebody from the baby boomers, you know about what age, or the younger baby boomers, or the older baby boomers. You know, you have an idea of about what age, instead of saying this age or that age, you know what I'm saying? So, but for them, it's always all of them. All of them do this. All of them do that. Okay, and in their mind, they are always the victim of whatever it is. If it's the male or female, or if it's that generation, or it's that age, they can go to an age group. You know, say people in their 50s, they're this way, or you know, age group, the whole cohort, you know, the whole decade, and or they can just you know, that whole ethnic group, and sometimes it's even their own ethnic group. Okay, and all other ones are great, but their own is bad. They're always the victim. They don't, you know, they say all of them do it, and they're always the victim. Okay. And the reason this is on my mind is because I've said this before, my life seems to go in themes. This seems to be the latest. I've seen it so much, you know, this happening. And it's both males and females doing it. And actually, I'd say one male, two females, you know, doing it. And for me, you know, as you all know, I'm not a healthcare professional or provider. This is not counseling advice, anything along that line. Read the disclaimer in the description box below this video on YouTube. Got it out. And anyway, to me, it's good to make it like a, you know, to write a little outline in my head, you know, put the symptoms of, and, you know, because if you can have everything in your head, ooh, might explode. But to have that in my head, so when I see the behaviors, I pull it out of that little compartment. Oh, don't compartmentalize. Yeah, but I have it, you know, I have these down. I have these behaviors, you know, I know them. I know them for what they are. And then, you know, don't generalize, but then see it. See if that is what it is. Does that make sense? Okay, let me give some examples, you know, hypothetical, fictional, or composite, something like that. So you see a couple, a younger couple, and the guy is putting off that he really loves his wife. Okay, they're a young couple. He really loves her, really cares about her, and she's so wonderful, and she's the best, this and that, and everything. And there's two different ways that it could go, that one being, like, she is feeling, showing, expressing, that she is just, you know, she's loving it. She, you know, she thinks it's sweet that he says this and all. Another one could be that she's starting to see the truth, and she's feeling, showing that she's uncomfortable because she's starting to see that he's a liar. He's just using her. And now she's expressing this discomfort, and it's gone beyond that over time to where she's not returning any of that. Then he will start acting like he's the victim of her, that he always loved her and she just didn't return it. He's setting it up. You see, he's been setting it up all along that he really loves her. You know, in case something goes wrong, like she figures it out, he can then say that he really loved her. It was her. She was the one who was doing this or that or the other. You see what I'm saying? Okay, so basically, he starts playing like he's the victim of her. You see that? Now, the other one, let's say it's a woman. She, you know, she can do the same, that and the same thing, but how about a different situation? Okay, let's make this a little more of a story. Say you're at your work, your job, working Cubeville, and it's a big, big place, and the boss decides to, and the supervisors decide to cross-train people. So they move people around and everything, and you run across this woman who is, well, she talks a lot, a whole lot. She's a little younger than you, same generation, you know, like, say, Generation X or Baby Boomers or whatever. And she's a little young, you know, somewhat younger, next decade or something. And she's very loud. And she talks on, she takes her breaks at her desk, and she talks on her cell phone. And she's loud when she does. And so people can hear, and she's got so many opinions. Everybody knows her opinions there. Okay, and over time, you hear her say things like that every guy she's ever dated is, you know, she really likes them, but then they turn out to be these users or these losers or these, there's something negative about them. She'll say things about, you know, maybe even other women, you know, oh, other women would accept this or, you know, something, but she is going to say she's the victim. Always she's the victim of these other people. And she finds reasons to say it about everybody. Because really, to her, you don't know this. I mean, she is that narcissistic type. And nobody in the world really, she doesn't say it out, you know, outright. But nobody in the world really is better than she. You know, you see what I'm saying? That's how she sees it. She knows everything. Experts don't know it. She does. She knows better. There's all, you know, that those kind of people who always say things like, any kind of expert, well, there's always somebody at the bottom of the class. You know, there are fields like mental health fields or medical fields. Everything I've ever heard, read, know for a fact, especially like around here, the bottom of the class would be a B average. Okay. The bottom of the class would be a B average. And the people who love to say that, that, you know, there's always somebody at the bottom of the class, they're usually people who've never even been in a class. You know? They've never been in that kind of class. They might have degrees in something else, but never been in that kind of class. So they don't know. But they have that part of their personality. That is part of this personality for some who have narcissistic behaviors, is that they know better than every professional. Every profession, everybody in the world. You see what I'm saying? Yeah, they're all, and they're always, you know, say they are the victims or try to tell people that they could be the victim. That man's about to run over that thing. Anyway, I'm going to go in the store. Enough on this video for now. If you want to subscribe, click the circle. If you want to watch another video, click one of the rectangles. If you want to share on your own social media, feel free to do so if you can. And I'll talk to y'all later.